morning and welcome to the UU Treehouse. I'm Steven Mead with friends with another story that we can have fun with and learn something from. You're all looking very decorated and very festive with hats. We're going to tell a story today about hats. It's called God's Hat. It's a story about listening. Once upon a time, there was a village with a road that went straight through the center of town. And one day, something strange happened. God walked down the road, and she was beautiful. She wore a long, flowing robe, and on top of her head, there was a wonderful hat. And all the people stopped to stare at God as she walked by. And they kept staring until she disappeared into the distance. Yes. Boy, God sure was beautiful, said one man. What a beautiful blue hat she had on. Yes, God was beautiful, said a woman from the other side of the street. But it wasn't a blue hat she was wearing. It was a red hat.
You're wrong, said the man. It was definitely a blue hat.
No, you're wrong, said the woman. It was definitely a red hat. And as the two argued, others joined in the dispute, and soon the whole village was arguing, and all the people on one side of the road were certain that God was wearing a blue hat, and all the people on the other side of the road were certain she was wearing a red hat. And people got mad and started screaming at each other, and finally the people got so angry that they decided to build a wall that went straight down the center of town. And from that point on, the people on the side of the wall were enemies with the people on the other side, and they never spoke to one another. And on one side of the wall, people built a church where they worshipped a god that wore a blue hat. And on the other side of the wall, people built a church where they worshipped a god with a red hat. And many years passed, and the people were still enemies. And then one day, God came walking back through the village again. She was smiling and balancing on the top of the wall that the people had built so many years ago. This time, she was wearing no hat at all. And all the people ran to the wall and cried, "You must settle our argument." "Yes, yes," said one man. "The people on the side of the street say you walked through the village many years ago. You were wearing a blue hat, but we know better. You were wearing a red hat. So tell us, God, what color was your hat?" God looked puzzled for a moment, began to scratch her head and thought, "I think I remember walking through this village many years ago," said God. "And on that day, I believe I was wearing my hat that is blue on one side and red on the other." And saying nothing more, God continued walking down the wall until she disappeared into the distance. Well, it was very quiet for a moment. See why. And suddenly there was the sound of one child laughing. And then another child started, and another, and soon the whole village was roaring with laughter, and everyone was laughing because they realized how foolish they had been. And as the sound grew louder and louder, the wall began to shake and crumble until finally it came tumbling down to the ground. And for many, many years after that day, people told the story of God's hat and how they'd been divided and foolish. And for you grown-ups who may want to delve more into this theme of deep listening, join me as I facilitate 7,000 Ways to Listen based on the work of poet and philosopher Mark Nepo. Through readings, meditation, and dialogue, we will explore the many gifts and challenges of deep listening as we reflect on the meaning of life that we are living. 3 sessions, Wednesdays, November 4th, 11th, and 18th, 1 to 2:30 p.m. For more information and registration, go to our UU Santa Fe news and events webpage or just view your weekly newsletter.
Join me.